Hi, I'm Andrew Dowling, veterinarian with the PGG Wrightson's technical team. Welcome back to our tech tip series on drenching. In this video, I'm going to discuss quarantine drenching. Now these tutus here have come back from grazing. So I want to make sure they don't bring back any resistant worms from the farm they've been on. So I'm going to give them a quarantine drench. In this, the drench choice and what I do afterwards are very important considerations. Now in a previous video, you may have seen me set up this drench gun. So now it's set up for the weight of the heaviest tutus in the mob, which is 70 kilos. So 7 mils out of my gun, and I checked it by putting the 10 squirts into the container. So I'm happy there. Now for my choice of drench, I've gone with Zolvix Plus because it's got the novel anthelmintic monipantyl in it, plus abamectin. If a farmer's using a triple combination drench as their routine drench, then I can't use that to quarantine them back in because I could end up bringing triple resistant worms back onto my farm. So I'm going to drench these tutus today, but this is not going to kill the eggs, which will still pass over the next day or two. So where these tutus graze in that time is critically important. I want them to be grazing in a paddock where there are plenty of other worm eggs. So somewhere around the yards where I've had a lot of sheep for the last month or two would be ideal. They can graze here for the next 2 days and then they can go out onto the farm. So that's quarantine drenching. The right drench choice, done well, and then for the next 2 days, making sure those eggs aren't contaminating clean areas of my farm.